Learn how to add sticky scrolling to your Figma prototypes in 8 minutes. Figma's prototyping feature allows you to create many interactions between wireframes in a Figma canvas. Prototypes are critical to communicate the design ideas effectively to stakeholders and developers, so designs are both understood and implemented correctly. Creating most interactions is easy by dragging one node to another and setting the interaction specifications. Other advanced interactions aren't as intuitive. This includes adding scroll behavior to certain elements, like headers and side panel menus. Here, you may need your designs to have multiple regions of scrolling on the page. This is tricky to learn at first, but becomes easy with practice. Today, we'll learn step-by-step on how to apply sticky scroll to your Figma designs, so you can have this advanced feature mastered for your next UX project. Step 1 is to identify what elements should have certain scroll behavior. Let's look at this example Figma design for a grocery website called Farm Fresh. The design is mid-fidelity and doesn't have any prototyped interactions yet. The screen is showing search results for coffee creamer. I've gone ahead and prepped the design frames and auto layout for scrolling. To dive into the frames, for this parent frame of the screen, I have 2 primary child frames, a header and main. The header includes this navigation bar and banner, and the main content includes the breadcrumbs, left panel, and the product listings. As a user scrolls, I want the entire header and the left side panel for the filter menu to remain and stick on the page. Since these elements are important for the user's navigation, it's important that they remain visible at all times. The remainder of the design, like the breadcrumbs and the product cards, I want to scroll as the user scrolls. For the filter menu, there are filtering options not shown by default, and I want users to be able to scroll through the menu without the menu disappearing from the screen. As we'll see, this is where sticky scrolling in Figma will come in handy. Let's first set up the scroll behavior for the parent frame and the header element. Step 2, we'll set up the scroll behavior for the parent frame and the header element. First things first, let's test out the current prototype. I'll swap to the prototype mode in the design file in the properties panel, then select the preview button in the top right corner. When I first play this prototype, it doesn't scroll at all. This is because the parent frame has a scrolling behavior of no scrolling for the overflow content by default. If I select this dropdown, I see I have the options for no scrolling, vertical, horizontal, and both directions. Because my content scrolls vertically, I'll select the vertical option here. Now, when I play the prototype, all the content scrolls, including the elements I don't want to scroll. This is because all elements have the scroll behavior of scroll with parent assigned by default. To fix this, I'll set the header element to stick to the top of the page. I have 2 options here. I can set its position to be fixed or sticky. If I set the element to be sticky, you'll see the element stops at the top of the screen, but all the content scrolls above it. I can fix this by right-clicking on the element and selecting Bring to Front. Or I can set the element to be fixed. This automatically brings the element to the front, as you can see in the layers panel. It created 2 sections in my screen, one for fixed and one for scrolls. As a tip for using fixed position, the element can't be in a parent frame with auto layout applied, unless the element is absolutely positioned. So, if the fixed option is grayed out, this is probably why. Since the header element is already at the top of the screen, both approaches work. Step 3, let's set up the scroll behavior for the left panel with the filtering options. For the left panel element, simply setting the position to fixed won't help because there'll be an awkward amount of padding between the panel and the header. Not to mention, the option is disabled for me to select. This is due to the constraints I've added from the auto layout. So, I'll change the position setting from scroll with parent to sticky. When testing this, I see the panel scrolls a little under the header, which is not what I really want. I want the panel to scroll until it hits a bit under the header with a bit of padding between. To see why this is happening, we need to understand how sticky scrolling works in Figma. Sticky elements scroll at first, but become fixed once the top reaches the top of its direct parent frame. So if you scroll up again, the element unsticks and moves down its parent frame. Ultimately, the sticky element stays within its direct parent's bounds. This means when the direct parent layer is scrolled out of view, the sticky element will continue scrolling with its parent. As a tip, to account for the header element being fixed to the top, You may need to add extra padding to the element you want to stick, which is what I've already included for this left panel. Also, because the direct parent frame of the left panel is set to hug all the content, including the product listings, it will scroll out of view. For the sticky scrolling to work properly, I'm going to shorten the parent frame so its bounds end where the screen ends, then change the overflow and the properties panel to vertical. Now testing this, the left panel stops just underneath the header while the product listings scroll under the header. When I scroll back up, the left panel scrolls back to its default place. Step 4, let's add scrolling to the left panel with the filters. Now that the left panel sticks to the top of the screen, I want the user to be able to scroll through the filter menu items. To do this, I'm going to select the frame that includes the left panel and go to the properties panel to set the overflow to vertical. Testing it out, I can see I have two separate scrolling regions now, but I want the left panel header that says Filter Products and the Clear Filters button to remain in view so the user keeps the panel's contact. To do this, select the frame with the header and button, then select Sticky for its position. You may need to add padding or a background fill color to this frame so the content scrolls properly underneath it. Not only can I create different scrolling regions in the same screen, but I can also add separate sticky elements in parent-child frames. Lastly, for step 5, let's test the final prototype. From the Figma file, I'll play the prototype instead of previewing it to view the prototype in a dedicated tab. Here, I'll make sure the scrolling interactions are all working properly. The header and left panel are sticking to the page as intended, and the left panel scrolls so the subheader remains in place, but I can still access all menu items. Now, I can press the share button in the top right corner to send the prototype directly to my teammates so they can also interact with it. There we have it! Now my prototype includes more advanced scrolling interactions that I can actually show to stakeholders and developers for feedback and design handoff. I hope this tutorial helps you master sticky scroll in Figma and you can use it for your next UX project. Thanks for watching. Make sure to subscribe to LogRocket for more UX design tips and tutorials.